Hi Leo, welcome to your reading, Leo. Let's see what messages will show up for you. Let's see, Leo, what spirit wants you to know. Leo, this is a collective message for your sign, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, and also North Node. So please take what resonates and how it resonates for your overall situation. Okay, let's see, Leo, what do we have for you? What do we have for you, Leo? Okay, inner wisdom we have. What else we have for Leo, please? What do we have for Leo, please? What do we have for Leo? Thank you. Communication. Okay, so what do we have? We have auras, observe, inner child, strength, and destiny. So something here is happening behind the scenes, Leo. We have tea. Inner wisdom. There is awareness. I'm getting strong energy of awareness here, Leo. You know exactly what's going on. You are guided. And for some of you, it might be a case that soon you'll get an invitation and you'll meet up with your friend, someone from your inner cycle. You will spend a nice time. It might be like a tea party or lunch. With the letters, communication, important communication showing up here for you, Leo. There is a need for you to simplify things with this inner child card. Okay, you know something. I mean, I'm getting very, very intuitive, Leos. You might be seeing auras, but it's like this inner wisdom and observe. This is like a hermit energy. You are very, very strong. Emotionally very strong, and something is happening behind the scenes with this destiny card. Therefore, if you know you have doubts or you're unsure about something, try to maybe distract. I don't know how to say it. It's like you deserve to be happy. You know what I mean? With this inner child. It's like you deserve to be happy. And I feel that it might be something that you might be waiting on. Or maybe there's some sort of important communication that can change a lot. Or can influence a lot. And you are stressing out. Maybe there is something, you know, that's playing on your mind. And you have this tendency to overthinking or overanalyzing. With the inner child, spirit wants you to know that things will be fine. That there is nothing here to worry about. Okay, this is a very positive card. And this card is showing up in so many readings, really, which is great. So this important communication here, it's coming in. I'm getting, when you will receive it, it will be something like, I knew. Like you would say, for instance, I knew that this person will say it, or I knew that they will word it that way. Something like this. But spirit is emphasizing here that you possess, you are very wise, and you should trust your intuition. Okay? Your inner voice. Something here will play out to your advantage. Will manifest the way you want with this destiny card. Very nice. Let's see, what do we have for Leo, please? Okay, your energy, it's very strong. Very strong. So we have Ten of Wands. Okay. Ten of Wands, Knight of Pentacles, Seven of Swords, Four of Swords, the Tower. You might be dealing with Aries. I also have Scorpio energy. And Nine of Pentacles. Okay. Alright. Queen of Cups. I'm seeing you healing, taking a break, withdrawing your energy. because of some sort of lies or being stuck in a certain situation for a long time that within time became a burden with the Ten of Wands. You are releasing it, you know? And I feel that, you know, the time finally, it's coming. It's like it's coming. It's just one more push, you know, you keep going. Ten of Wands represent the strength that is showing up here, because it's like you didn't give up. You keep on going. You are very emotionally strong. And I feel that you're going to release a certain situation that you might feel that you've been stuck in for a very long time with the Knight of Pentacles, as it is as this knight represents you being very patient. It might be a case that you were giving someone so many chances, or you were just waiting for a right moment. But I feel that within time, something here or someone became a burden, and it started being exhausting, tiring, you know. With the Ten of Wands is this energy of, again, exhaustion. I'm getting, it felt essentially like something or someone was draining your energy. Something very draining here with this Ten of Wands. We have Ten of Wands, the Tower, and Seven of Swords. I'm getting a very, quite difficult energy. It can represent a situation that someone was not, someone was unfair, essentially. They were sneaky, they were lying, they were telling you a different story, they were acting the complete opposite way behind your back, and Tower moment happened. But with the Tower, there is this sense of release, enlightenment, and freedom, liberation. And the Ten of Wands is showing that you will release burden. And it might be a case that it will be quite shocking here for someone involved in that situation. But at the end of the day, you want to focus on yourself with the Nine of Pentacles. And that's the bottom line. Four of Swords, it's this energy of healing. We have Four of Swords, Knight of Pentacles, Nine of Pentacles. This is pre-Empress energy. I feel that you've been through a lot with this, with these cards, absolutely. And I feel that you were stuck, or you've been stuck in a certain situation for quite some time. And you have enough. It's draining, it's too much. There were many Tower moments. And actually now, you are going to make a decision. And for someone here, it might be quite shocking. You know, this is something unexpected. They don't expect this. And I feel you choosing yourself. You're putting yourself first with the Nine of Pentacles, attracting abundance and prosperity. And I feel this is something that you've been waiting for a long time to do. But, you know, maybe at the time circumstances were not favorable. But I'm seeing you taking time, healing. You know, maybe you're preparing yourself for it. Please take it how it resonates. But I'm seeing that kind of a huge energy of freedom. And it can be emotional freedom. It can be intellectual freedom. Please take it how it resonates. You dropping this burden represented by the Ten of Wands. And it will be quite shocking for some people, because they don't expect that you will do it. Maybe there is a family situation here, you know, that someone is taking your kindness for weakness, and you feel that you have so many responsibilities. You know, you are left there alone by your own, and you have to carry this burden. There is no support. More people are taking advantage here over you, and you are saying enough, it's enough. No more. I've been trying to tell you, I've been trying to guide you with the Queen of Cups. I was trying to, yes, someone will take your kindness for weakness, and you have enough. That's it with the Tower. Four of Swords, you'll be fine, and you know that. With the Nine of Pentacles, you're focusing on yourself, and I feel that's the ultimate goal here, to kind of recharge your batteries with the Four of Swords, to heal. And even if it means that it takes time, that's fine. I'm getting that for you, you have time. I don't know if that makes sense, but you know what I mean. When it comes to you and your matters, and it's not the case of being selfish, no. It's the case of you don't want to agree for less than you deserve. You're putting yourself first, because for a long time you've been giving so much love, affection, you've been very caring, loving, but someone was taking it for granted. And I feel you coming from the place now, now it's my time. I want to be happy. I want to do things that I've always wanted to do. I want to be independent, because Nine of Pentacles is this ultimate energy of independence and being very self-sufficient. Very powerful energy. Very powerful. It's like I'm choosing me. You know what I mean? It's I'm putting myself first. Maybe even first time ever. Because I see you being so generous, so loving, and so caring. But enough, it's enough. You're attracting abundance, good luck, and good fortune with this Nine of Pentacles. That's a beautiful energy. From Ten of Wands to Nine of Pentacles, that's a massive change. Because you see how different this energy is from this one. Show me the past for the year. Show me the past. Show me the past, please. Three of Cups. Four of Pentacles. Ten of Cups. King of Pentacles. Knight of Swords. Magician. Queen of Swords. Okay. So in the past, I see here a nice relationship. Four of Pentacles. Do you know what I'm seeing here, Leo? Is that someone hasn't forgotten about you. They are, with the Four of Pentacles, it's like they are, if you, okay, so if you ever, if you've been wondering about someone from your past, if they still remembers you, or if they ever loved you, or if they ever cared, the answer is yes. They are still stuck on you. Three of Cups to the Four of Pentacles to the Ten of Cups. Queen, King of Pentacles, Knight of Swords, the Magician. For some of you, Leo, there was a connection and it looked like, you know, a very happy relationship. But I feel that you were dealing here with someone who liked their independence, but to the point that they got distracted and they started to give to another situation, or they started giving to another situation with the Three of Cups. It's like this person wanted to be in relationship with you, but equally wanted to have their independence, and it's like they wanted to have their cake and eat it too. With the Four of Pentacles, yes, they were very kind of, this is what they wanted. That sort of dynamic. Because it's too, it's already too crowded. We have a Queen of Swords, we have a King of Pentacles, we have a Knight of Swords, we have the Magician. Leo, you might have dealt with Virgo, Gemini, or you might be dealing with Virgo, Gemini. But what I am seeing here, that this person was very convincing with the Magician and the Knight of Swords. It's like they were telling you that they are all about stability with this King of Pentacles. And with the Queen of Swords, they appeared being perfectly transparent and honest with regards to what they were telling you. But this Magician with the Knight of Swords, that gives me a vibe a little bit of someone who is quite good when it comes to words. And they can use it to their own advantage. It feels like there was a dynamic, or you were involved in a connection that was making you happy with the Ten of Cups. And this person was happy with you. But equally, it's like maybe they had some sort of habit with the Three of Cups. Maybe they prioritize at the same sorry. Maybe they are prioritized at the time they friends and certain lifestyle. But I feel that at some point this person got distracted. For some of you, this is someone who put you in a third party situation and they wanted to keep this connection and the other one with the Four of Pentacles. And they were trying to convince you that they're all about the stability, that they truly care. But I feel this person wanted their cake and eat it too. This is someone who's still thinking about you. They are missing this Ten of Cups that they had with you, Leo. Show me near future. Show me near future for Leo, please. We have a King of Swords. We have a Three of Wands. Oh, and we have an Ace of Wands. And we have a Knight of Swords. Well, in the near future, you have someone here in your energy who wants to chase you. And interestingly enough, Three of Wands to the Ace of Wands gives us Four of Wands. This is someone who wants relationship. With the King of Swords, they have so much to say. They want to talk. This is someone who wants to talk with the Three of Wands. They are waiting on the right moment, and this moment it's coming. I'm getting someone also who might be, you know, keeping their eye on you. Oh, sorry, keeping their eye. They're having their eye on you. Meaning observing, right? Gosh, sorry for my broken grammar. Observing your social media. This is someone who's very curious about what's going on, about you, what's going on in your life. With the Ace of Wands, it's like they're waiting the right moment to manifest, to communicate, to come with communication. And with the Knight of Swords, they are hugely motivated here to put their point across, to kind of present their point of view, their side of the story. They have so much to say. You have someone here who wants to talk, but this person ultimately wants relationship with you. You might be dealing here with someone who sees you as their twin flame. But because it's not fully the Four of Wands, it's like they're hiding it. I don't know why I'm getting that. They are not fully transparent with their intentions. But intention here is to have a conversation and have relationship with you, essentially. Three of Wands, Ace of Wands. This is something that they want to manifest. So I'm getting very strongly that in the near future you can expect communication, absolutely. King of Swords. Person who wants to talk, they want to chase you, and they will chase you with the Knight of Swords, big time. Because their ultimate goal is to manifest relationship with you. You have someone who wants to be in relationship with you. Show me love life. I'm also seeing you achieving something that you've wanted with the Three of Wands, because this is expansion, it's growth. It's this ship finally arriving, therefore this goal of yours that, you know, I feel that you have your eyes on the prize. And this communication, like a very important communication with the King of Swords, will arrive, and it will like give you a green light for you to finally take an action on something. Could you show me the love life, please, for Leo? Love life for Leo, please. Thank you. We have a King of Pentacles. We have Eight of Cups, and we have Queen of Swords. So we have a king and queen. We have a match. Someone, Oh my gosh, and we have a Queen of Pentacles and King of Pentacles. What is going on? Okay. So, Leo, in your love life, I'm seeing here this King of Pentacles, this energy, male, female, please take it how it resonates. This is someone who walked away at the time, but it feels like they're coming back. With the Queen of Swords, they want to have, I feel this is someone who wants to court you, and they want to have a conversation. And they want to come across as someone who is telling you the full truth. We have a Queen of Pentacles here at the bottom of the deck. This is someone who will tell you that you are their divine counterpart. Yeah. Terrifying. They want a higher level of commitment. Four of Wands. That's what I'm getting. It might be someone from your past then. It doesn't have to be. But I'm seeing here someone who wants a higher level of commitment. You might be dealing with Taurus. They will tell you that, you know, that you are their divine counterpart, that, you know, you match energetically, that it flows, that it makes sense for both of you to be together. With the Eight of Cups, I feel this is someone who walked away at the time, or maybe you distance yourself from them. But with the Queen of Swords, they want to talk. Again, we have like a double confirmation. Because they want a high level of commitment. Four of Wands, and now we have a Hierophant. Someone wants relationship with you. Someone really, really want, they really want relationship with you here, Leo. But I'm getting also that it might be complicated. Therefore, there might be need for you to release someone or certain situation. I don't know, it's just so complex. Either way, I'm seeing here Leo, someone who will express their feelings. You can expect a love letter or some sort of communication here of affection. But this is someone who walked away. Or you lost contact with them with the Eight of Cups. But Eight of Cups, it's more like someone walking away because something here is not working for them. In their own understanding, of course. Well, either way, I'm seeing here communication, many conversations, and finally I feel this person will indeed say that, you know, it's always been you. That's what I'm getting. Shall we try again? I want to be with you. I want to have a high level of commitment. I want to take this connection into the next level. During this time apart, I've understood many things. I had time to think about the whole situation. Yes, they want to tell you they how they see it. It's something to do about, they have so much to say. They want to present their point of view. Mm-hmm. But ultimately, this is someone who wants Four of Wands and a Hierophant with you. Relationship, high level of commitment. Wow. Let's see the outcome. Could you please show me the outcome for the near future for Leo, please? So we have the World. We have the Knight of Cups. We have Strength. Your energy, and we have this Hierophant here at the bottom of the deck. You might be dealing with another Leo. I also have Scorpio, Aquarius, strong Taurus. Yes. Very strong Leo, very strong Taurus, Aquarius, Scorpio. The World, Knight of Cups. Strength to the Hierophant, higher level of commitment. The whole reading is about some sort of form of commitment here. with someone. I am essentially seeing you a closing certain cycle with the world. I feel that, yes, with the Ten of Wands, there is this energy of release. And with the world, in your outcome, it's very visible that something like this, it's taking place, or it will take place very soon. But it's something I feel that you will feel very happy about. And then we have a Knight of Cups and Strength. So someone who feels very strong, who share a very strong bond with you with this strength, it's coming with an offer of love with this Knight of Cups. Offer of love, offer of commitment. It's like you will end certain cycle here with something or someone, and automatically you will give space for the new, and that will bring someone here, I'm getting back, to your life, who will express that they care, that they've always loved you, that they made mistakes, that, you know, but it's always been you. And I'm getting this offer of commitment. It's like, would you like to accept this cup of love? Would you like to give me another chance? Because I want to share this cup of love with you. With this trend, I'm seeing you being very diplomatic about it though. You know, it's not like you will immediately jump into the situation, no. That's why maybe we have this observe, and we have strength as well in these oracle cards, because you possess a certain, you possess this inner wisdom, you know, you've been there, you've seen it. And also I feel that you are kind of at the end of certain kind of situation here, that it took so much strength from you, but you didn't give up. And it's like, oh, this situation ended, and now this person appears. You know how it is. When we least expect something, it has a tendency to appear. And that's what I am getting. And with this trend, I'm seeing you being quite diplomatic, but also holding back a bit. It's like this person will have to prove that they truly means business here, that they truly mean business. But you have opportunity, and Spirit is emphasizing here that there will be opportunity here to reconnect, to have a reunion or reconcile with someone. And this person here is coming with an offer of commitment. So this is what might manifest or happened here during the next 11 days in your life. But either way, I'm seeing you having this personal satisfaction, being happy, being in your element with the Strength card. Leo, I will leave it here. Thank you so, so very much for being with me. Please like, share and subscribe. And once again, thank you very much for your time. I truly, truly appreciate you. Leo, have a fantastic and wonderful day. And once again, thank you very, very much for being with me. Take care. Bye.